In this video, I am going to share with you details about the development board of 8051, which is developed by Silicon Techno Lab. So I'll share with you how to purchase this board, what are the different peripherals available on the kit, what are different accessories you will get along with this kit, how to download drivers of the kit, and finally how to download and execute a program using this kit. This is not a sponsored video, but recently I have worked on this kit, so I want to share my experience with you. This is 8051 quick starter kit developed by Silicon Techno Lab. So this is the description of kit, and here the price is listed, that is $1,150. So this kit uses 89S51 IC, microcontroller IC. We'll go through the details of this kit. So along with this 8051 kit, you'll get ISP programmer kit, one USB cable, and one connector cable to connect this ISP kit with microcontroller kit. The kit is having a main IC here, 8051 IC, 89S51 IC, and peripherals available on kit are LCD, 8 LEDs, red color LEDs, one switch is connected, and you can insert RTC IC here. This is the adapter where you can connect a supply to this kit, and this is the on-off switch of this adapter. Now if you connect this ISP programmer to this kit, and if you use a USB connection from PC, then there is no need of this external supply. But when you want to execute your program only on kit, you have to connect the adapter here. This is the power supply circuit, and here one red LED is connected. When it will glow, it indicates the kit is getting a supply. Then this is a reset switch. So whenever you want to reset the microcontroller, you can press this switch. Then all four port connectors are shown here. These are 8 terminals of port 0. 8 terminals of port 2, then 8 terminals of port 1, and 8 terminals of port 3. Here you can see the pull-up resistors for port 0. Using single strand wire, connect any peripheral device to port of this IC. Then 5 terminals are available for 5 volt supply, 5 terminals for ground, and 5 terminals for 12 volt supply. So these ports we can use to interface any peripheral devices. This is RS232 connector. So for serial communication programming, you can use this RS232. This is the crystal circuit. So crystal of 11.0592 megahertz is used here. These are the capacitors along with this crystal. Then one switch is connected internally to pin P3.3. So you can write a program to interface this switch to microcontroller, and you can test it using this switch. Then this connector or jumper JP1 is used to connect your microcontroller kit with this ISP in system programming kit. So here there is a connector, and the connector with this wire is also given with this kit. So you can use this connector wire to connect this ISP kit with the main kit using this connectors. Then this is for RTC. You can interface RTC with microcontroller using this socket. And this is the power backup battery. Then for LCD, this is the preset available. Using this preset, you can change the contrast of LCD. Then LCD control signals, that is EN, then RW, RS. For this control connections, these three terminals are available here. And 8 data bus can be connected using this connector. So here it is written DB0 to DB6. If you want to interface LCD, you can use a single stand wire to connect these lines, LCD pins, to any of the port pin. Then 8 LEDs are available. Red color LEDs are available here. And to connect these LEDs to any of the port, here these terminals are available, D0 to D7. So we can use this kit to interface the peripheral and test program. So along with this main kit, you'll get ISP kit, one USB wire and one connector wire to connect ISP with main kit. Here on ISP kit, you can see here USB connector. So using this USB connector and USB wire, you can connect your microcontroller and ISP kit to your PC. You can download program using this USB connector. Now here download option is also provided and few documents are available here. When you click on this 8051 quick starter board diagram, you will see the diagrams of each circuit available on the kit, like power supply diagram, then switch which is connected to P3.3, then LED, then serial communication, reset circuit, ISP connector, and the all circuits combined together, pull-up resistors used, then LCD connection, LED connection, and the RTC DS1307. So everything, all diagrams you can see here in this document. To use this kit for programming, you have to download a drivers for this kit. So I will provide the link of this driver in description box. So when you will click on that link, you'll observe this Win driver here. So download this Win driver, just click on this download option. This .rar file will get downloaded. Keep that folder on your desktop or any other folder. That is enough. Just download this Win driver .rar file. Now, if you are using Windows 10, then you have to disable the signature. So I'll explain you how to disable the signature for Win10. And after doing this, you can download a program on a kit. Click on Start, Power, then press Shift key and click on Restart. You'll get this message, getting Windows ready, don't turn off. Then you'll see this option, click on Troubleshoot. Then click on Advanced Options. Then here you have to click on Startup Setting option. Then again click on Restart. So disable driver signature enforcement we want to do. So for that you have to click on Restart button. Again computer will restart. And now you have to press number key. So we should press the number key 7. Now we need a software to download a program into IC or burn program into IC. So for that, on the same website, go to the download link, and here you'll find PROGISP V1.72 for AVR and 8051. Click here. This RAR file will be downloaded. Compressed file will be downloaded. You can extract this and place it anywhere on your PC. I have already extracted it. and place on desktop. So open this file, open this folder, and you'll find this exe file, progisp. Click on this exe file. You'll see this screen. So here you can click on the load flash. Select the hex file. Select the folder where you have stored the hex file of program. So click on open. Now hex file is selected. You have to just download this hex file into your kit. You have to connect your kit using USB cable to your PC or laptop. And after loading this hex file, click on this auto. So if your kit is connected and if you click on this auto, your hex file will be downloaded into kit and the message will be displayed here. That's all. Your file is downloaded and as per your program, you will observe the output on the kit. So you can purchase this kit and you can use it for testing a different program and interfacing different peripherals to microcontroller.
Make all the demons quiet, yeah. We were built to thrive, yeah.